Hello friends, welcome back to the Design Patterns video series. In this video, I'm going to discuss shallow copy and deep copy in C sharp with examples. This is a continuation part of our previous video. So please watch our previous video where we discussed the prototype design pattern in C sharp with examples before proceeding to this video. Shallow copy and deep copy play important role in copying the objects in prototype design pattern. So at the end of this video, you will understand what are shallow copy and deep copy and what are the differences between them in C sharp with example. In the case of shallow copy in C sharp, it will create the new object from the existing object and then copying the value type fields of the current object to the new object. But in the case of a reference type, it will only copy the reference, not the referenced object itself. Therefore, the original and the clone objects refers to the same object in the case of reference type. Let us understand shallow copy in C sharp with an example. In order to understand this exam, please have a look at the above class. So this is the employee class, right? So this employee class is having three properties. Name and department are value type, whereas employee address is a reference type, that is of type address. So further, if you look at the definition of address class, so it is only having a single property, that is address. This employee class is also having one method, that is getClone, and this method uses the memberwise clone method to create a clone object of the current instance. So a current instance in the sense on the object on which this getClone method is called, and then return that clone object to the caller of this getClone method. This is going to be our client code. Let's see how we can create a clone object using the getClone method. So as you can see, first we are creating one employee object, that is emp1, and then setting the name, department and employee address properties. As name and department are value types, so we are storing the value directly. Whereas employee address is a reference type, so we are creating an object of address and setting the address property, right? Then we are creating the second employee object, that is employee2, by calling the getClone method on the current instance, that is on the employee1 instance. So when the getClone method is called, so it will create a clone object of employee1 as we are calling the getClone method on the employee1 object, and then return that employee1 object to the caller of this method. So here, right? So now we are having two objects, employee1 and employee2. Then we are updating the name and address property of employee2, right? And then we update the name and address property of the employee2 object. To understand how the shallow copy internally works, we need to understand the memory representation of this code, right? Now let us see the memory representation. So when these four statements are executed, then what will happen? So two objects are created in the heap memory, one for the employer and another for the address, right? So name and department are value types, so it directly store the name as Anurag and department as IT, right? Employee address is a reference type. So instead of storing the value directly, what it will store the base address of the address object. That is why you can see 1010 is storing in the employee address, right? So this is employee1, so it is a reference variable which is going to be created in the stack memory, and this reference variable will hold the base address of this object, that is 2020, right? So these things are happening behind the scene when these four statements are executed. Now, when the fifth statement, that is this statement, is executed, then what will happen? So this getClone method, or you can say this memberwise clone method, create a clone object and return that clone object. Clone object will contain the name, department and employee address properties, right? So name will be Anurag, department will be IT. But here the important point that we need to understand is employee address, right? So this employee address will also pointing to the same address object which is created previously, right? And then a reference variable, that is employee2, will be created in the stack memory, and this employee to reference variable will hold the base address of this object. So if you notice, the reference type field, that is employee address, is pointing to the same old memory location in both the employee object. That means both the object, that is EMP1 and EMP2, are now referencing to the same address object. So if you do any changes to the employee address, then it will affect both the employee objects. Let us see this example practically. So far, what I have done is I have created one console application with the name deep copy and shallow copy. Then I have added few class file to this project, right? So this is the address class file, and here we are creating a simple address class. This address class is having a single address property, right? And then I have added another class file with the name employee.cs, and this employee.cs class file is having a single class, that is employee, right? If you notice, this is the same employee class that we have already discussed. So this class having name, department and employee address properties. Name and department are value type, whereas employee address is a reference type. Then this class is also having a getClone method, and this getClone method uses the memberWiseClone method to create a clone object of the current object and return that clone object from this method to the caller of this class, right? Then this is the client code that we have already discussed. So from this main method, first what we are doing is, first we are creating an instance of an employee object, that is employee1, and setting the name, department and employee address properties. Then we are creating the second instance, second employee instance, by calling the getClone method, and this getClone method will create and return a clone object of this employee1 object, right? And then we are changing the name and address property, right? So we are changing the name as Pranay, we are changing the address as Mumbai, right? As the address property, as the address is referenced by both employee1 and employee2, so when we do any changes to the address, then it will affect to both the employees, right? So let's run the application and see the output. Yes, you can see the address of both the employees is set to Mumbai. That means both the object referencing to the same address object. This is called shallow copy. Shallow copy will create the new object from the existing object, and then copying the value type fields, that is name and department in our example of the current object, to the new object. But in the case of a reference type, that is EMP address in our example, it will only copy the reference, not the referenced object itself. Therefore, the original and clone object refers to the same object in the case of a reference type. Now, I hope you understand shallow copy in C sharp. Now, let us understand deep copy in C sharp. In the case of a deep copy in C sharp, it will create the new object from the existing object and then copying the fields of the current object to the newly created object. If the field are value type, then a bit by bit copy of the field will be performed. If the field is a reference type, then a new copy of the reference object is created. Now let us understand deep copy with an example. For better understanding, please have a look at the below code. This is the same example that we have discussed in the case of shallow copy. Here we are having two classes, employee and address. But for now, if you look, the getClone method is available in both the classes. So this address class having getClone method, which will create a clone object of this address, right? And this employee object having getClone method, this employee class getClone method will create a clone object of the employee object, right? So if you look at the getClone method, first we are creating a clone object and storing that object in the employee reference variable, and then we are setting the employee address. But for now, for setting the employee address, we are calling the getClone method of the address object, right? And this is the client code which is going to be same, right? So we are creating an instance of employee1, setting the name, department and EMP address properties, then creating the second instance of the employee object by calling the getClone method on the first instance of the employee object, then say, updating the name and the address properties, right? So this is the same code as the previous example. Now let us understand the memory representation of this example, right? So when the first four statements are executed, then what will happen? So two objects are created in the heap memory. One is for employee and another is for address, right? The base address of the address object will be stored in the employee address reference variable, and the name and the department, as they are value type properties, they hold the value directly. And the base address of this object will be stored in the employee one reference variable, which is going to be created inside the stack memory. Now, when this statement is executed, that is the fifth statement is executed, then what will happen? So it will create a clone object and return that clone object. So this getClone method will create a clone object of the emp1 object and return that emp1 object, right? So in that case, it will create a brand new object, right? So as you can see in the memory architecture, a brand employee object is created inside the heap memory, as well as a brand new address object is created inside the heap memory. So this memory address is going to be stored inside the employee address reference variable, and the name and the department value as it is, right? And the base address of this object is created, the base address of this employee object will be stored inside the employee 2 reference variable, which is going to be created inside the stack memory. So the employee address is a reference type property, and in deep copy there is a clone of the reference type field that will also be stored in a different memory location. So the point that you need to keep in mind is, in the case of a deep copy, the field type doesn't matter whether it is a value type or a reference type. It always makes a copy of the whole data stored it in a different memory location. Now let us move to Visual Studio and see this example practically. So first, what we need to do, we need to add the getClone method inside the address class, and the return type of this method is going to be address, right? So return, so it will return an object of type address, and this will return the object by calling the member wise clone method. This is the change that is required in the address class. Now let's move to the employee class. So in the employee class, instead of returning the employee clone object directly, what we are doing, we are storing this object, clone object, in a reference variable, right? And the return type of this method is going to be employee. Then what we need to do is, we need to set the employee address property, and to set the employee address property, what we need to do is, we need to call the getClone method on the employee address object, and then we need to return the employee object from this method. This is the change that is required in the employee class. That's it. We do not want to do any changes in the client code, that is in the main method of the program class. Now run the application and you will see that name and address are going to be different in both the employees. So let's run the application. Yes, you can see name and addresses are different in both the employee object. In employee 1, name is Anurag and address is BBSR, and in employee 2, name is Pranay and address is Mumbai. So the point that you need to keep in mind is, in the case of a deep copy in C sharp, the field type doesn't matter whether it is a value type or reference type. It always makes a copy of the whole data and store it in a different memory location. I hope now you understand deep copy in C sharp. In the next video, I am going to discuss factory design pattern in C sharp with examples. Here in this video, I try to explain the shallow copy and deep copy in C sharp with examples. I hope you enjoy this video. In case you need the code and text version of this video, then the link for the same is provided in the video description section. Thank you for watching this video.